I am Marco Cecchetti, an associated software engineer of Collaborative Productivity, and I am going to show you how we get chart editing in place, chart editing working in online, in Collaborative Online. First off, I will start with a quick review on how chart editing works in LibreOffice from the user point of view. When a chart is inserted in Writer, you will get the chart diagram with axis, axis label, chart legend. If you insert it, also a chart title. It's possible to set up every aspect of a chart through dialogues properties, colors, fonts, fonts, effects, the line style of axis as this dialogues allows to do. And obviously, you can set up the two most important things, the chart type and the data series for populating the chart. So what of all these from a programming point of view, instead, a chart is controlled by the chart controller that implements a main interface. Its controller, its dispatcher, its dispatcher supplier, its selection supplier. The chart controller, indeed, is used both per dispatching command to a chart, such as a copy command, paste command, or triggering the creation of dialogues for setting up the properties I was listening earlier. And that is performed through command handlers of the type execute dispatch and then the command name. So what of the feature I was talking about is available on Collaborative Online? I would say the 90% of the feature is available at the present, but at the start, indeed, the only thing you succeed in doing was to activate the chart by double-clicking on the chart area. Never else was working. What was the problem to get chart editing working in online? The first was to forward mouse events to the right windows, because when a mouse event occurs in online, the message is sent to the lock core that should send it to the right windows. But what the lock core was doing is to send all events, even the one that occurring in the chart area, to the document windows. Another problem regarded the chart rendering. That because online is like a map split in tiles, and so we needed to render the chart on the tiles that it intersects. As for all the possibility to set up the properties of a chart, that has been possible when we implemented the dialog tunneling solution. This solution is a global solution that works for all LibreOffice dialogues. And when we get this solution implemented, adding support for chart dialogues has not been more difficult than adding support for the other LibreOffice dialogues. If you are interested in more details about the dialog tunnel, you can read the Pranav Akant talk he given in Rome in 2017. So, for getting chart editing support in Collaborative Online, we implemented a class named the Lock Chart Helper. This class have a lot of methods. Here you can see the core methods. When you create an instance of a doc chart helper, you pass it a pointer to the view shell. And through this view shell, the instance can retrieve the chart window, can retrieve the dispatcher for dispatching command to the chart. The command I was talking earlier, chat copy command, past command, or simply triggering the creation of some property dialog. And finally, you have also a method for getting a chart bounding box that, as you can imagine, use it for getting the bounding box of the chart area in tips. So, when the client sends a mouse event to a mouse event message to the lock core, this message is handled to the high-tiled rendering post mouse event implementation. There is an implementation of this interface for every document module, such as Writer, Calc, and Impress. For instance, here you can see the implementation for the Writer case. In Lock Chart Helper, as a similar method called in the same way, post mouse event, this post mouse event method check if there is an active chart, and if the point where the mouse event occurs is on the chart area. If that's true, it returns true, and that the execution stops. And instead, if it returns false, the event is handled in the usual way by the document handler, except in a case. This case is when the mouse event is not a simply mouse move, but is a different mouse event, but it occurs on an activated chart area from another view. That is, we want to avoid that a user try to activate or through drag a chart that is actively edited by another user. That is performed by the static lock chart method itany that iterates over all view shell looking for a possible active chart for that view shell, and if it try one, it returns true. Another case where we needed to implement a specific method it was for the set text selection. That is when the client tried to set the current text selection. That can occur when the user drag one of the text selection handles, for instance. What happens? The client can send a message for setting up the start selection or the end selection point. We have implemented a similar lock chart helper method that obviously check if the event is occurring in the chart area, and in the case it creates a specific command named lock set text selection that is dispatched to the chart controller by attaching as argument the parameters of the client message. At this point, at chart controller dispatch method, where all commands are forwarded to the real handler, we parse the argument, and we handle them through the execute dispatch lock set text selection method. This method simply is able at the chart controller level to retrieve the edit view that is editing the text that maybe is editing in it the user is editing the chart title or any title of an axis, and to perform the correct sequence logic position action. And this is what regards the handles of mouse event and command forwarding from the client to the chart controller. Another aspect, obviously, has been the rendering of the chart on the tiles. For this, we implemented a specific chart helper method named paintTile, which get the virtual device represented the tile. And what it does is to check if the chart area and the tile intersect, and needed a unique conversion because online works in TWIPS while the chart works in 100 millimeters. And then computed the correct scale factor and the chart offset between the top left of the tile and the top left of the chart. And to set up the map mode for the virtual device. And finally, to pass the configured render context for the tile in this way to the chart window point that is responsible for rendering the chart. And so in this way, we get the chart rendered on the tile. However, there is one thing we need to take into consideration. There is a unique version of a tile per each view. So when we render a tile, we need to render all active chart for all view. And this is performed by the lock chart helper static method paint all charts on tile that iterate over all shell, create a lock chart helper instance on all view shell, and then check if there is an active chart and paint the chart on the tile using the method we have seen in the previous slide. So finally, obviously, we needed also to a method for notify the client about an invalidation so that the client is able to request to the lock core the needed tiles that intersect that invalidated area. That is what was needed to get the in-place chart editing working in online. And there is, however, some minor features that, however, can make the user experience better. So, as you can see, this is what you get when you select a graphic object in online. It can be an image, it can be a shape, as in this case. You get a selection rectangle, a dot selection rectangle, and you get several handles. Some are resize handles, and there is also a rotation handles on the top, on the center top. Okay, that's fine, but the problem is that we get always this, even if the graphic object was not really rotable or resizable. And that can be a bit misleading for the user, and also because sometimes occurred that you drag a resize handles, and when you release it, nothing happens. But what's worse, the selection rectangle doesn't return to the previous position. So it was very odd. The solution has been to modify sending the graphic selection message that the lock core send to the client by appending a list of properties. This list of properties, in this case, specify for each action that the user can perform on the graphic object what is valid and which is valid and which is not valid. In this way, the client is able to resolve some problem as this one. Why I have started talking about graphic selection, because the fact that there is a graphic object that are not resizable or rotable is especially true for charts, because for instance the title is only draggable, as the chart legend is not rotable. And finally, there is another feature, minor feature, but not nice. When you create a pie chart with detached slice, on the LibreOffice, it's possible to drag this chart segment. However, you can drag it everywhere. You can drag it only on a constrained direction. This direction is the bisector of the pie segment that obviously pass through the center too. How we get to work this in online? We simply extended further the graphic selection message by adding some extra drag info. We specify the drag method so that the client know that have to perform some kind of constrained dragging, and we specify the drag direction so that the client knows what is the direction where the constraining has to be applied. Essentially, the move vector is projected on the drag direction so that the final effect of the user dragging is to move the pie chart only on the bisector axis. Moreover, since Henry Castro has implemented a way to have a preview of the dragged or resized graphic object that usually for shapes and image works, but it didn't work in this case, we append also a latest property to the drag info record. This property is simply an SVG document that represents the pie slice, so that it's possible to see the pie slice when the user is dragging it. Okay. I thank you for listening and for expecting that I succeeded in getting the laptop working. And for me, that's all. If you have some question, I don't know.